only is Clive Palmer very rich, he has also been nominated for Good Samaritan of the Year. The award recognises people who act selflessly and for the benefit of others in the community, and the winner will be announced next month.
That's because he's agreed to buy the next 12,000 Holden Commodores to come off the line.
About Clive Palmer's humanitarian side?
No, I don't, but I wouldn't be at all surprised if he was a generous donor. Look, isn't this just Clive Palmer bashing? aren't we just doing Paul Poppy knocking here? Why has everyone got... What if he is nominated for the Good Samaritan Award? Good luck to
him. Who's nominating him? The LNP?
It's a Salvation Army. It's a Salvation Army thing, isn't it?
I think, yeah, look, I don't know.
Did they nominate him, or did someone else nominate him?
I don't know how you get nominated.
Oh, I imagine
probably bought the nomination.
I imagine you donate a huge amount.
Sarah. No, that's
Christmas.
Unfair. It is
very unkind of
you. You donate a huge amount of money to people and they do what you want. It worked with the LNP. Presumably now it's working with the Salvation, who I love.
If people didn't donate money and time, there'd be a lot of people in Australia who didn't get a helping hand.
Yeah, and you've got to give it to him. I mean, you know, you have all of these champagne socialists who bang on about, you know, making everything equal and giving to the poor, but put your money where your mouth is. Donate.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'd be very interested to see Clive Palmer's donation to the Salvos as a fraction of the amount of money he donated to himself to get himself elected.
No clap there.
Can't say anything bad about Clive Palmer.
Should we say?
I just wonder why you say it.
Because he is a businessman who misrepresents himself. He called himself a professor when he only had an honorary professorship with his donatathon. He's someone who entered Parliament for purely selfish reasons because he didn't get state government approval for a giant railway he was trying to build to his mind so he could make more money. He then pretended that it was this big crusade he was going on about how he's a man of the people.
Tell us what you think.
And then he suddenly repaints himself as this champion of the oppressed. He comes up with all these dangerous policies which make absolutely no sense, such as we'll, you know, boost health spending by billions of dollars but cut taxes to a flat tax rate at the same time. And people are falling for it because it is gobbledygook. It is fairy dust politics. And everyone believes that the lowest 5% of voters believe it, and they say, oh, you know, this is perfectly rational, vote for Clive. There's no way that anything he does can possibly be achieved. It undermines the whole political system. Yeah. It undermines politicians of genuine merit.
He got in because people voted for him because he was an anti-politician. Mm. They knew he was talking nonsense and tosh, but they didn't care because what he was someone who was a fresh face in politics, and they were so sick of the way things had gone in the last couple of years in particular, that's the wave that he surfed in there. So it's really for the political classes, the established political classes, to essentially not become so heavily on the nose.
I can understand certainly that people are fed up with the last 3 years of Australian politics, and I have been incredibly disappointed myself, but the answer is not just electing kooks to Parliament and giving them potentially the balance of power in the Senate, where things like the carbon tax and other important legislation will be decided effectively on the whim of a madman.